And therefore, you would say that they have early satiety. They may also have postprandial nausea and belching or abdominal bloating. And the only thing that helps you in this is history. There's hardly any investigation in the routine sense which kind of helps you. And the alarm symptoms need to be ruled out before you say that this is functional dyspepsia, in the sense that if it's an older patient who's come in for the first time with a 1 month history of dyspepsia, who has pain, vomiting, associated other symptoms like weight loss, a GI bleed, jaundice, or fever, or any other family history of carcinoma stomach, then in that case, it's best to directly jump to investigations rather than treat empirically. Because if it's a routine 20-year-old boy who's just come from outside the, from living in the village, come to Hyderabad with this high-tech parents, gets a little nervous about coming to the city and starts experiencing these food-related symptoms while his exams are also coming. So then I would say maybe this is functional and give him some treatment, say you appear for your exams, then you come back and then we'll see you again. But if a patient has any of these alarm symptoms, we shouldn't be waiting for anything, just directly go on to investigations first. So that's the first message. The second main function is emptying. In the emptying, liquids empty first and solids empty in a very phase-like manner, what we call as a log phase. Here, if you have ever, most of these are men here, and I see a few women. Now, if you have looked at the top of a mixer, if you open a mixer while you are grinding something, if you look at the top, anybody has seen it from the top? So, when you look at it and you start grinding some solid, what you will find is that if there's too much of water in it, it won't grind. That is why water needs to be emptied first from the stomach. If there is only solid, then it will grind like a solid. That means if it's something dry, it will not grind as well if you want to make it into a paste. So you put some water slowly and you find that when you look at the mixer, things will come from the sides and come to the center. And you see this as a continuous movement. Okay, go home and see it. And you realize that the stomach empties exactly like this. Whenever the there is a trituration of solids because of antral contraction. When the material reaches a size of about 1 to 2 millimeters, it drops into the center of this flow and is emptied out because the pylorus is open only for 1 to 2 millimeters during the emptying phase. So this is important to understand, and that whenever there is delayed gastric emptying, there's not too much, there's a lot of solid that remains in the stomach, plus there will be large particles where there is where they have not been crushed to size. However, during the fasting state, the pylorus is open up to 2 centimeters. That is why your endoscope can go in, even your ERCP and endoscope can go in, and coins, large coins, can pass through the pylorus in this state. So important is that emptying has to be normal for so that there are no symptoms of that the patient can perceive. Now, why do we think of using psychiatric drugs in patients who have functional dyspepsia? Many of these patients who have functional dyspepsia also have associated irritable bowel and chronic pain syndromes. However, these studies have been small studies, and therefore whether we get any message out of these studies is not yet clear. TCS, tricyclic antidepressants, do not influence gastric motor function or improve satiety. Amitriptyline has been useful in some select studies if patients have not responded to an ACE inhibitor or a prokinetic. So also for imipramine. And in this select group of patients, that means you've taken off patients who responded, now you've got a small degree, small number of resistant patients. In them, the number to treat, number needed to treat is only 5. Which means imipramine actually looks promising, but long-term results of these are not yet available. Coming to the SSRIs, there's only one study of the SNRIs which has been published, and venlafaxin was not found to be any superior to placebo in that single good study. Of course, there are other small studies of other SNRIs. Now, this is a functional dyspepsia treatment trial, which is a trial of 14,000 patients across Europe and the US, where they are doing a stepwise treatment, randomizing patients to amitriptyline, escitalopram or placebo. And these studies were presented at the DDW this year, and they found that there was a borderline relief with amitriptyline. Escitalopram was much better. Of course, placebo also, there was a 30-40% relief. And that is what the problem comes up, that if there is such a high placebo response, what are the treatments that we give? Now, beside the drugs, the other treatments that people have tried are giving meditation, yoga, trying to counsel patients to change various lifestyles, and you find that some of these again have temporary relief, but none of these have been maintained for long.